section of motion in 2D. The another section of motion in 2D is circular motion. Alright? And then comes the projectile motion. Alright? So first we will study the circular motion, because I think most of you were, how many of you are there in the bridge program? Okay, how many of you are not there? That will be lesser. Only 3 or 4. Okay. So we will be doing projectile motion again. So here lies your chance to again learn it from scratch. And those who think that they have already learned the projectile motion properly, here is your chance that you have 1 week where you can do higher level questions on whatever you have done till now. Okay. So since many of you have already done projectile motion before, I will be doing projectile motion at the end. Right now I am doing the circular motion. Okay, please write down circular motion. What is a circular motion, anyone? What it is? Motion in a circle. Very good. Motion in a circle is a circular motion, but that is the mathematical distance. Mathematical way of telling it. Okay, let me ask you in a different way. When you will say that object is having circular motion? Speed is constant, but velocity keeps on changing. But it can be done like this also, right? Speed can be constant, velocity keeps on changing throughout, but this is not a circular motion. Displacement is? So I can go like this. From point A to B, I travel like that. And is this circular motion? Acceleration is constant. Is that the way you define circular motion? In a projectile motion, acceleration is constant. G is acceleration. So I can throw an object up, it comes back in a straight line. Speed is? Oh, speed should also be constant. Is it required that in a circular motion speed should be constant? No. So how will you say that object will move or should move in a circle? Displacement must be? As in, although that could be correct, I mean, you're describing it, but it is not concise. I mean, it is not very, very clear, crystal clear. Anyone? Ajay, tell me how you make a circle. As in, when the circle will be made? When distance from the fixed point is? Fixed. Okay, when the distance from a fixed point is fixed, which is radius, and the particle is moving, we'll say that it is circular motion. Okay, now again that is little mathematical. So what I'm doing it is that you draw these two points A and B. Are you seeing any circular motion here in the room? Fan. Fan is one of the examples that you have taken. So suppose this is a fan. Entire fan is moving in a circular motion. Blades are moving in a circular motion. As in the entire blade in a same circle. Then each point, let's say this is the point. Is this point moving in a circle? The radius is this much. I mean, from here to here is the radius. Is this point moving in a circle?
Yes.
This is the circular motion of point 2. This point 3 is also moving in a circle like that. Now you can see that as you move towards the center, the radius is decreasing. And in the same time, 1 is going to 1 dash, 2 is going to 2 dash, and 3 is going to 3 dash. 1 is telling the more distance. Yes or no? So point number 1 is going faster, Point number two has to go slower because it has to travel lesser distance in the same time, and point number three goes the with the least speed. Okay, but whatever it is, we can see that it is all the points in the fan, they are moving in a circular motion. And where is the center? Center is this axis of rotation only. Okay, so center of all the circles, every point on the fan is moving in a circle with the center fixed. So we have a concentric circle. Lot of concentric circles are there. Are you getting it? Alright, now let's further study as in what if you are not at rest? Suppose you are moving, will you see fan doing a circular motion? When I'm moving like this and looking at fan, will it go in a circle? Suppose fan is at rest. Suppose fan is at rest and I go like this. How will I see the fan? It will move in opposite direction. Relative velocity. I am the observer, so I will see everything after subtracting my velocity. Okay, fan is at rest. So when I move like that, I look at the fan will appear to move like that in opposite direction. Just like when you are in a train, moving train, you look at the trees go in opposite direction, but yes, you know that trees are at rest. Okay, but I am saying that what you are observing, I am not saying actually what it is. Getting it? So you will see that the fan is going in opposite direction of your velocity. Okay, and then fan starts to move, let's say rotate. Now every point with respect to center is moving a circle and also going back relative to you. Fine? So the kind of path it will follow is this. Are you getting it? It will be much more complicated path, but definitely it is not a circle with respect to you. Suppose I am going like this, fan is at rest, fan will appear to go in opposite direction. And on top of it, fan starts to move also, like that, rotate also. So while fan is rotating, it is going back, like this. Are you getting it? So all the points motion changes. Getting it? So, is it true that fan does the circular motion with respect to observer who is at rest? Okay, let's analyze it. So I have taken fan just as an example. It need not be just a fan, it could be anything. For example, if A and B are the two points, if I say that distance between A and B is fixed, let's say L is a distance. Let's say distance between A and B is L, and that distance cannot change. It cannot increase and it cannot decrease. Alright, now can point B move relative to A? If distance is fixed, can point B move? How? B has no other option but to move in a circle. Are you getting it? So that the distance between A and B is fixed. Alright, so when distance between two points is fixed, then one point, if it has to move relative to other point, it will be circle only. Getting it? When I am moving, my distance from the fan is increasing. So with respect to me, the fan cannot move in a circle. Alright? But when you look at the fan, the tip of the fan and this point, the distance between these two points is fixed. And if this point has to move relative to that point, it has only one option, circle. Right. Now tell me one more thing now. Distance between two points is fixed. Point A and B, we have discussed that point B will move in a circle, right? Can point A move in a circle with respect to B? Is the center of the span is also moving in a circle relative to the edge? It is at rest with respect to observer who is at rest. Suppose you are the observer, you are at the tip of the fan. Then will it move in a circle? Suppose this point B observes relative velocity of A. B's motion is like this. So motion of A will be what relative to B? Opposite direction. Getting it? So relative to edge, the center is also moving in a circle. Fine? So definition of center is hypothetical in physics. Center is just, you know, a point where observer is located. Even the center, this point which was center, can be moving in a circle related to that point. Getting it? If you observe this point related to B, B becomes center and A goes in a circle. But why we always see that center, with respect to center only it is moving in a circle? Because we are at rest and center is also at rest. So whatever is happening with respect to center, I can also feel because I am also at rest. Are you getting it? So I am only seeing what can be observed with respect to the center of the fan. Are you able to understand what I am trying to say? But if I starts to move in a circle like this, somehow let's say there is a device which also moves in a circle like this with the fan. So suppose this point is going like this and there is a point which also travels like this with the same velocity in a circle. So this point will come to rest relative to that. Are you getting it? Fine. So this point will be at rest. Now you will observe that point is going in a circle. The center is moving in a circle. Okay. So when we will observe the circle motion? When the distance between the two points is fixed and one point is moving relative to other. Okay. Very generic. Please write down. Circular motion is observed when the distance between the two points is fixed. When the distance between the two points is fixed and one point is moving relative to other. So the relative motion is your circular motion. All of you understood? Any doubts? No doubts? Understood, right? Now usually what will happen is that usually that fixed point as in the observer is at rest. So that is why we say that distance from a fixed point, if it is constant, then it is circular motion. But what I am saying is that the center need not be a fixed point. Do you understand that difference? Initially we have discussed that the distance from a fixed point should be fixed. What I am saying is that the point need not be fixed. Okay, point may be moving, but you are observing everything with respect to that point. Because you are observing everything relative to that point, motion of that point is zero. Because the observer is standing on that point. Fine? Usually what will happen is that we will only consider those circular motion where the center is at rest. We will observe normal circular motions only. But there is a chapter in your syllabus, it is called rotational motion, rigid body motion. You might have heard of it. Okay. It is considered to be the most difficult topic in entire physics, 11th and 12th combined. So, circular motion is the beginning of that chapter. In fact, this should not be the topic of motion in 2D, but we are studying it properly now itself, so that once that comes, you will already have some hang of it. Okay.